Hey guys, today I'm going to review this little Spark clone. It's supposed to look like the Spark. It's the YH19. I don't know offhand who the manufacturer is. It just has this logo on it. It comes boxed really nicely with foam inserts. I'm not going to go over all that, but as you can see, it's one of these foldable drones. The arms fold in. It's got the props that swing out and lock into place. It's quite portable. Just pull them out, lock them into place, and you're ready to go. It has a 720p camera on the front, and that camera can swivel all the way up, which is really strange. But you can at least aim it up enough that you can get the horizon. But you also get the props in the view, so I like it to be more towards the level, just so you get less of the propellers in the view. I have the battery in there, so I'll go ahead and show you the lights. It's got blue LEDs in the front and green in the back for orientation, and also a red light. So that helps you locate the rear. So it's really easy in orientation. These lights are fairly easy to see during the day. Now I'm in a sort of a dark garage now, so the lighting here is not the best. I apologize for that. But it's even easier to see them here. The battery it comes with here is it's a 1S LiPo. It's 800 milliamp hour. Gets you about 8 minutes and 15 seconds flight time. So pretty good flight time out of this guy. With a 45 second LVC, which is about what you want. So really good on that. It charges using, this is being a proprietary battery. It charges using a micro USB cable that comes with it. So even though it's proprietary, at least you don't have any kind of funky connector. If you lose your cable, these micro USB connectors, everybody's got tons of those. This takes several hours to charge. It's kind of slow to charge. It has a red light in here that comes on, and it goes off whenever it's fully charged. But I'm pleased with the flight time out of it. It comes with two sets of spare these props and a Phillips screwdriver to replace them. It's got three rates, and the yaw does increase with the rates. So it's a pretty nice flyer. It's not super sporty. But I was flying it in really windy conditions and was able to get around, though it wasn't super easy, but I was impressed I was even able to fly it around in those conditions. It uses the record to there's a micro SD card, and it does not come with one, but that's where you record the video, and that's going to be a lot better since being 720p. The video I recorded had a little jello, and I was in a lot of wind, so it might not be as bad today because it's not nearly as windy. Like I said, I recorded 720p video, and the video was decent. It had decent detail. It was, I'd say, average to maybe slightly above average, especially if there's no jello, because I was in a lot of wind. That might have been aiding to the jello. We will find out. You have to use, at least if the app is bound up, I believe you got to use the app. We'll start recording to the SD card. It only records to the SD card. It does not record to the app. Now, the instructions does mention that this button on the back will start recording. Now, I didn't notice the light blinking any different. So I'm going to use the app just to be safe, but it could be that this will record, or it could be that this will record if the app is not bound up. And then this takes priority over the app. That I can't comment on because I've only flown it with the Wi-Fi FPV app on my phone. Here, it has this holder. I'm not going to get in here now because it's kind of hard to get my phone in. And you have to be mindful, if you've got buttons on the side, be careful so you don't end up turning your phone off, mounting it in here like my phone does. So that's where it holds it, and it's fairly comfortable. The controller, these antennas are certainly bogus. They're not real. They're just swivel around for looks, look like the Spark controller. I don't see any evidence of wires or anything that would make you believe that these actually are to increase the range. You got your left and right roll trim buttons here, and your up and down here is your pitch trim. You have a one key return button here and a headless mode button here. You press in on the left stick and that will start the propellers and will do an auto takeoff. And you press in on the right stick and that will do an auto landing. If you want to manually unlock them, you just go both sticks out and that will start the propellers up, and then you can take off. Both sticks in does a gyro calibration, which is interesting because the last drone I reviewed, the S10, did that too. I had not seen that before. But that does your gyro calibration until the lights stop flashing. Now, when you first power it on, the lights flash. It does a calibration every time you power it on, which most do, but it's letting you know it's doing that. So you shouldn't have to do a gyro calibration unless maybe you just crash it and it's starting to drift on you. It's got these top buttons here and then buttons behind it. And the instruction manual, I thought it was wrong. I made notes because it looked like it was reversed because I didn't originally see these buttons. But it's kind of goofy because this left button here, this first set of buttons looks like they have multi-function. So the instructions make you think it's these if you don't notice the button behind it. Because it says this is your rates and photo. And I think it means this is your photo and video. But the rates button is here. But if you press on the edge of the button, it doesn't do anything. It just beeps one time. If you press the upper part of the button, then it goes one, two, and three beeps for your three rates. And like I said, the yaw increases and the pitch and all that like you want it to. On the left one here, it says, you know, this is your motor kill, which is nice. It's a separate button. But when you're up on this upper right, you know, button, if you press the edge of this button, it does motor kill also. That's why I thought these were, I didn't even see these. Because your 3D flips, you have to go to the top. And then it beep, 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 and you flip the direction you want to go. So I don't know if that's just an error on their end or what. Since both of them, this one beeps and doesn't do anything, and this one does a motor kill. So if I think, I'll demonstrate that. Because I press this, the drone will, a few feet off the ground, I'll test it, it'll drop. If I press this, it kills the motors also. To do 3D flips, I have to go up on the top of the bumper, and then it does the flips. So it's almost like they designed it multi-purpose and then added these, and I don't know. It doesn't make any sense to me. But in the end, the fact that this motor kill and the 3D flip is also on this one bumper is just bad. You get it mixed up, you're going to have all kinds of confusion. And you're going to end up, if you're up too high, dropping the drone out of the air. So I don't know why these do this. If this should just be one button that does 3D flips, a whole press, and that is not the case. You've got to be very careful. So that is, to me, is just something I'm concerned about. You know, I like everything about this drone, but that. So I don't know what else to tell you. Just be super mindful to go to the top for flips. I don't think mine's defective for the fact that this one beeps once on this side, but then it beeps more times for the rates on the left. So it doesn't seem to be something wrong with my controller. So I don't know. Just all in all, kind of strange. The app that you use on this is called the YHFPV. And there it is. You can go into settings and turn 720p preview on. You do your play, make sure you connect to the Wi-Fi first. And then there's your photo and your video. Like I said, the video starts according to the SD card. 360 flips, your rates, gyro controls, on screen if you want to just use your app to control it, which I wouldn't advise. I'm not going to go over it anymore because it's like all the other apps. Everything now is Wi-Fi FPV. It gets to be like a broken record going over all that. So I think that we've covered everything with the drone itself. We'll go ahead and take it out now and demonstrate it and maybe kind of show you the stuff with the, the controls there and how that's a little bit confusing on the flips and the stuff on the top. So we'll be right back. Okay, so I have the YH-19 little Spark clone out here on my tarmac. I have it bound up. I've got it bound up with the FPV app. And I have the controller all set up. I have the little antennas up just to have them up so it looks cool, but I don't think it really does anything. So we'll go ahead and start recording to the micro SD card. It lights up yellow, so it should be recording. We'll go ahead and do an auto takeoff. Now I'll kind of try to demonstrate the flips. It only does flips left and right. I forgot to mention it does not do forward or back flips, which is not that uncommon for a craft that's a little bit longer, like this drone. It's a little bit of a longer craft. So we'll go ahead and take it up now. Like I said, I've got it recording. And I'll show you the motor kill confusion. Let's go ahead and press in the left stick and then go ahead and take off. That's a pretty nice auto takeoff. Now I'm going to demonstrate, before we do anything, I'm going to demonstrate that the motor kill. So the back button should be the motor kill. And as you can see, it is. So it did it as you expect. So I'm going to go ahead and pick it up and we'll bring it over here. Of course, I'm still recording the video. And we'll go ahead and it'll take off again. Now I'm going to press in on the, I'm going to bring it back. There's a bit of a southerly breeze today and it's blowing away. I'm going to press in on the first bumper on the outer side. Let's bring it back here. So I don't have to walk too far. And see, it did the exact same thing. So this button here on the in, on the outside or the back one, both are the motor kill. That I don't understand why it's doing that. That's where I had some confusion. I'm gonna go ahead and stop recording and start again because the camera got kind of knocked out of the angle that I had wanted it. So that is the confusion on the motor kill. Now I'm gonna go ahead and start recording now. I'm gonna do an auto takeoff again. Now to do 360 flips, you do the up part of the right. You see, now it flips. Almost hit the bushes there. So when you flip, you gotta make sure, and it flips really, really nice. Now if I try to do a forward flip, see, it doesn't do it. But left. So you just have to notice that. Now I am in the lowest rate, up on the upper left, two. And now the yaw gets a little better. Press it again. And now we've got three, and the yaw is even better. So probably not as much as I'd like to see it. Not nearly as much wind as the last flight, so hopefully maybe the jello's a little less. So the jello was not bad. I've seen way worse jello on toy drones than this, but it was not jello free. Yeah, it's not super sporty, but it's not slow either. Has a considerable amount of pitch, so it's able to fight, you know, some wind. Yesterday I was flying in 15-20 mile per hour winds, and that was an adventure. You know, it was not the best conditions. I shouldn't have been flying it in those conditions. I can see that there are some props showing up. I've got it set to level. I'm gonna go ahead and do an auto landing here. Ooh, almost got it on the tarmac. You can control it as it comes down. I'm gonna go ahead and stop recording again and maybe adjust the camera down just a hair. Just a smidgen. See if we get a little less props in the view. Go ahead and start recording again and go ahead and do a manual takeoff. Both sticks out, they start up. It seems like it calibrates the gyros every single time. Every time you take off, because they're not flashing now. I did do about a 30-second flight before I started this just to check everything again. So if I fly it all the way dead, it may not be to the 8 minutes. Should be, you know, 7 minutes. So the fact it records on a micro SD card is nice. You're not going to lose the footage as easily. You got to make sure you stop recording. But you shouldn't have drop frames. You'll get drop frames or a Wi-Fi. I didn't comment much on the Wi-Fi. I do like where it's held. It's much easier to fly and look down on that screen. But there is considerable lag, which you see in most of these Wi-Fi. Some are better than others. This is about on par with most of them in this category of Wi-Fi. So wouldn't you figure that my memory card on my camera would go full towards the end of this review? I had done some reviews and forgot to empty the contents off my head cam. So that's why the video flight suddenly ended there. But we got plenty of flight in. I was getting ready to land it and noticed that I heard a beep on my head cam and it was the memory card's full. It's never happened before. It's like a 32 gig, I think. I don't know. Anyway, went ahead and wanted to go ahead and finish it up here. Didn't want to end like that, but I went ahead and landed it. And like I said, overall, this is a nice little drone. I don't have any gripes the way it flies. I think I like how it records the video to the memory card. You know, I like a lot of the things about this. I love the way the controller feels. I got it on still here. And you know, it's a nice controller and I like the where the screen sits. The problem, of course, is this weird, you know, motor kill on both the back and the front switch, along with the 3D 360 flips being on the same button. So that's the one thing I would need I want to keep pointing out is be conscientious of that. If you buy this drone, make sure you know to push all the way up by the antenna for the 360 flips. Otherwise, I don't really have anything else that I have a problem with this drone for the price. If you're looking for a little, you know, if you like the DJI Spark, but you don't want to spend $400 for the controllerless version and you want something just to start out with as you're a learner, you know, this is a nice option, but of course it's just a toy. You're not going to get anything near DJI Spark video quality. It doesn't have GPS or anything. So there's a purchase link in the description to this on TomTop's website. So go ahead and check it out if you're interested in it. I appreciate for watching and have a good day.
The power of the dark side.